Hello students, I am Gnaneshwara TN, Assistant Professor of English. In the previous session, I had introduced you the characters in the story Engine Trouble. In this session, I am going to tell you the summary of the story. Engine Trouble by R.K. Narayan is an Indian story of unlucky draw. The story depicts the troubles of a common man after winning a road engine as a lottery prize. A showman owning an institution called the Gaiety Land came to the town of the talkative man. The talkative man is the narrator of this story and is our protagonist. He is a poor man. The Gymkhana grounds are used for the festivities and the whole town pours in to see the show. It provided them with all sorts of fun and gambling and sideshows. There was the doom of death and the lottery stall. The narrator bought a ticket of lottery and he was declared the winner of the road engine. His friends congratulated him for becoming the owner of a road engine. The narrator thought that his troubles were coming to an end, but his troubles had just begun. It was not the sort of prize one could carry home at short notice. There was not a single person for 50 miles around who knew anything about a road engine. The showman agreed to keep the engine on the Gymkhana roads till the end of their season. The man met the municipal authorities and the secretary of the club to sell it out, but no one showed interest to buy it. The municipality ordered him to remove it from the ground, otherwise they would charge him rent. He paid 10 rupees per month as rent. It was more than the rent he was paying for the house he occupied. He had to pledge a jewel or two belonging to his wife to pay the rent. Then a cattle show comes to town and he is given 24 hours time to remove it. At last, the narrator decided to move it from its place. He decided to put in the field of his friend. The priest of the local temple offered him services of his temple elephant. He engaged 50 coolies to push it from behind. The coolies wanted 8 annas per head. He took the service of Joseph, a dismissed bus driver, to steer it. Although he knew nothing of road rollers, he agreed to steer the road engine. A huge crowd gathered to watch it. The engine began to move. When it came out of the Gymkhana and reached the road, it began to move zigzag. The elephant dragged it one way. Joseph turned the wheel without any idea of where he was going. And 50 men behind it pushed it just where they liked. As a result of all this confused dragging, the engine ran straight into the opposite compound wall and reduced a good length of it to powder. At this, the crowd let out a joyous yell. The elephant, disliking the behavior of the crowd, trumpeted loudly and kicked down a further length of the wall. The 50 men fled in panic. The crowd created a pandemonium. The owner of the compound wall slapped the narrator in the face. The police came on the scene and arrested the narrator. When he was released from the lockup, he found several consequences awaiting him. Several yards of compound wall to be built by him. Wages of 50 men who ran away, Joseph's fee for steering the engine over the wall, cost of medicine for treating the knee of the temple elephant, which had received some injuries while kicking down the wall. Last but not the least, the demand to move the engine out of its present station. The narrator's family life is also disturbed because of the problems that the road engine has brought the narrator. Every day, his wife was asking him what he proposed to do with the terrible property, that is, the road engine. He had no answer to give her. She lost her temper and cried that she would write to her father to come and take her away. He himself also thought of running away to his village. At this point came an unexpected relief in the shape of a Swamiji who performs various impossible feats and insists on having a road engine run over his chest. The municipality does not have one. Our protagonist becomes the hero of the hour by lending his engine for the feat. Swamiji's assistant was trained to move any kind of engine. The narrator was pleased and decided to lend him the engine, and in return, it would be driven wherever he wanted it to. People gathered to watch the yogic feats of Swamiji. Unfortunately, a police inspector came into the crowd with a brown envelope in his hand. He told that the magistrate had issued an order prohibiting the engine from running over the Swamiji. The Swamiji got angry and went away in great rage. The narrator asked his assistant to take the engine over to his friend's field. He denied to do so, citing the Swamiji's unhappiness over the development. Suddenly, nature came to his rescue in an unexpected manner. One night, an earthquake hits the town. In the morning, when the narrator visits the place where the machine stood, he finds that it was not there. The earthquake had moved the engine from its place and fitted in a disused well like a cork. The owner of the well thanked the narrator because he wanted to close the well. So, he agreed to pay all the expenses on the man's behalf and requested him to leave the machine there. He agreed to withdraw all complaints and charges against him. Thus, the narrator finally got rid of the engine. Finally, he heaved a sigh of great relief. Dear students, let us recall what we have learnt in this session. A showman owing an institution called the Gaiti Land came to the town of the narrator. The narrator bought a ticket of lottery and he was declared the winner of the road engine. It was not the sort of prize one could carry home. The showman agreed to keep the engine on the gymkhana grounds till the end of their season. The man met the municipal authorities and the secretary of the club to sell it out, but no one showed interest to buy it. The municipality ordered him to remove it from the ground, otherwise they would charge rent. He paid 10 rupees per month as rent. A cattle show comes to town and he is given 24 hours time to remove it. So, he hired a temple elephant, 50 coolies and a dismissed bus driver to move the engine. The engine moved from its place but ran into the opposite compound wall and reduced a good length of it to powder. The police arrested the narrator. His wife cried that she would write to her father to come and take her away. He himself also thought of running away to his village. A Swamiji who performed his yogic feats wanted the road engine to run over him, but the feat was cancelled by the interference of a police inspector. Finally, the earthquake moved the engine into a disused well. In this way, the narrator got rid of the road engine. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.